Hi, more underwear? Is that okay? Cool. Today I want to be talking about Nikki. They are an organics basics brand for women. They have a variety of cuts from thong to high brief and a pretty modest selection of colors. They're mostly nude, but they do have some special, like seasonal ones that are wine, turquoise, and stuff like that. They do offer bundles. It goes from 3 to 20, and you actually do save some money if you bundle. I, of course, have the high brief. It is a French cut high brief, meaning that the sides go up in a V, which is awesome because it elongates the leg and just makes it look like you have very nice long legs. They're 95% cotton and 5% elastane. These are a bit stretchy. They are pretty soft and form-fitting, but not like super cutting into you form-fitting. They're pretty lightweight. They're about the average size for, a cotton, I want to say, underwear, not super thick like some of the polyester ones can be. For the average person, the elastic top isn't going to be super irritating, though I think for sensitive skin, you might want to be wary. This is one of the more uncomfortable elastics that I've worn in underwear for a little while. Also, as with my mama underwear, disappointingly, elastic threads started popping out of this after the first wash, and it's actually worse than the Wama one because they're very long. The brand says don't dry it, and this is gonna sound super privileged to me because I know the majority of the world doesn't use dryers, but in my opinion, if your underwear can't stand up to a dryer without, elastic threads falling out, I think that just speaks to the quality of the item. Insofar as shipping and packaging, this is a lot, so let me just reference my notes a little. It took me about 4 days to receive the package, so it was super quick shipping. Everything came in a pretty small, like, box, like almost something that you would get like a phone in, and it was all just bundled up. I got a pair of five. They're plastic free. They primarily use recycled content, low impact inks, and biodegradable adhesives. They try to use a high percentage of post-consumer recycled waste, and the box materials are certified with the Forest Stewardship Council, which essentially means that they just have good felling practices. They're felling in such a way that preserves the farm. Also, last thing with the packaging, it's designed to be reused with their underwear recycling program, and they have one of those, an underwear recycling program. So essentially, you can just take your old underwear, stuff it in the box, ship it off to them. Insofar as the brand's ethics, it's also kind of a lot. The website is pretty clear and informative. They really do try to make sure all their ethics are kind of front and center. And if you have a question, like you're probably gonna find it on their website. Being that this is an organics brand, you're gonna find that they push that a lot. They give a lot of reasons why organics is better. And they do say, what isn't in their underwear. So chlorine, formaldehyde, and just harsh chemicals. If you try to ask them what they mean by harsh chemicals, they'll kind of be elusive about it. But there's a lot of chemicals, so I don't really expect them to know it all. They also are very clear on their supply chain, starting where the cotton is grown, where it's ginned, where it's spun, woven, and dyed and cut and sewn. And all that's done in India. They're very clear about that. And it's mostly done in about two states in India. What's not clear on their website, however, is how often they visit these facilities, how they monitor them essentially. Something else that sort of concerned me with the website is how they espouse the use of hand-picked cotton. All their products are made in India. They're only shipped and packaged in the US. And in India, they pretty much only hand-pick. They don't mechanically farm cotton for a variety of reasons. With India, the cotton varieties there aren't synchronized, so you have some cottons that mature faster than other cottons. Tractors essentially just aren't picky enough, so they have to get people to actually go in and pick them. Also, other necessary machinery that's used in tandem with tractors isn't suited towards Indian cotton. A benefit of hand picking is that it leads to cleaner cotton, so you don't need to process it as much. You don't need to clean it, need to do that process essentially. But on the whole, like any cotton that's bought from India is probably going to be hand picked just because machinery is too expensive and it's not suited towards Indian farming. Indian cotton farming practices. So they say, like, we use hand-picked cotton because it offers jobs, but the reality is, like, they have to if they want cotton from India. They want to have everything done in India. Like, they have to use hand-picked cotton. Besides all that, they have a lot of certifications, like that stewardship council thing. Of course, they're GOTS certified. They're also fair trade certified. That means they have pretty good labor practices. And they have an OECOTEX certification. So that's about dyeing, that they're using safe dyeing practices and safe dyes. Safe, so safer, not as toxic to the environment. And of course, on top of that, they have the recycle program. That's great. So yeah, that's about the gist of it. To be honest, even though it got a little dark at the end, I really do love this underwear. I love the cut, and I love that they do bundles for a pretty affordable price. I mean, affordable when you get into this territory. They are $13 a pair. So of course, if you're used to like going to Victoria's Secret and getting 5 for $25, that's a little eh. But on the whole, bundles are pretty good. I just have an issue primarily with the elastic at the top. It's ridiculous to me that elastic threads are coming out so profusely. I really haven't had these for a long time. Also, the actual elastic is like warping. So in my opinion, they just didn't use a high quality elastic for the top. Some might say, who are actually, you know, into buying really high quality clothing, what do you expect from underwear that's $13? And did I say touche? All right, so yeah, I'll see you guys next video. Bye.